Ensuring your plant haven remains toasty throughout the colder months can be a bit of a puzzle. So how much heat do you really need? How can you make sure that you're not wasting the energy? We have a helpful tool to help solve this heating conundrum, or at least we'll know what BTUs you need for your greenhouse heater. Greenhouse size heater calculator. Are you ready to dial in the ideal warmth for your greenhouse world? Let's get calculating. Now let's start with the fundamentals. As you embark on your quest for the perfect heater, you've probably come across the term BTU. What does that mean? Well, BTU stands for British Thermal Units. Now, the BTU represents the amount of heat energy needed to raise the temperature of one single pound of water by 1 degree Fahrenheit at sea level. So in simple terms, it's all about measuring heat. When you're scouting for greenhouse heaters, you'll notice they all boast different BTU ratings. This tells you how much heat a device can produce. Choosing the right BTU rating is paramount. Why? Well, an underrated heater won't warm your greenhouse adequately, but yet go way too big, you risk unnecessary energy consumption and accelerating wear on your unit. So as you venture into the world of greenhouse heaters, remember the importance of BTUs. It's not just a number, it's the key to ensure your plants get the warmth they need efficiently and effectively. Now, one of the most pressing questions that we do get is, why does heater size even matter in a greenhouse? Isn't it just heat? Well, not quite. Underheating is the very first pitfall. Just like us, plants get chilly. In an underheated environment, they become susceptible to frost damage. Their growth slows and their overall health deteriorates. So on the flip side, there's overheating. You might think the warmer, the better, but plants like Goldilocks prefer conditions to be just right. Overpowering heaters can lead to several problems. First, they can literally burn your plants, especially the delicate ones. Second, they consume more energy. However, you know, most heaters do come with a thermostat that'll shut the unit off once it reaches a certain temperature. But with that being said, an overpowered heater means high electric bills, which, you know, in today's world, we're really keen about trying to keep that down. It's not just about saving money, it's also about the energy conservation and reducing our carbon footprint. So, in a nutshell, the size of your greenhouse heater is critical. It not only impacts the health, but the energy consumption and the finances of your pocketbook. That's why precision, which our calculating tool provides, is inevitable. But now comes the next big question. How do you actually calculate BTUs? You know, calculating BTUs is a blend of math and understanding your specific needs. It's not just a one-size-fits-all formula. Step one, measure the surface area of your greenhouse. We're not talking about the floor space, since we need to heat a room. This means we need to take the height into consideration as well. To do this, you'll have to measure all sides and calculate the surface area. Well, let's take the Jance's Junior Victorian, the JVIC 23 greenhouse, as an example for our calculations. To make it easier, we'll use rounded numbers. So the JVIC 23 is an 8x10 with a peak of 8 feet and the sidewall height of 5 feet. It also has a regular house shape. This means it will have two identical sides and a front and a back that are identical. Okay, so here's the math. Now we know that our sides are going to be equal length and equal height. We also know that our roof is equal length and equal height. So therefore, we basically have four equal sides. So therefore, on the sides and your roof, it'll be 4 times the total sum of 5 times 10. That'll give you a grand total of 200. For the math of our gables, now the gable ends can be a little complicated, but if you break it into two simple steps, it's a lot easier than you would think. Think of it as a rectangle and a triangle. Our bottom wall or our bottom area is going to be the rectangle, which is 5 foot wide or 8 foot wide, 5 foot tall. Now we have two of those, front and back. Now with our upper portion, our triangle, that's got to be 3 feet because our entire height is 8 feet. So here's our formula. It's going to be 2 times the grand sum of 5 times 8 plus 2 times the grand sum of 8 times 3 divided by 2 is going to give you 104. Now, if you take those calculations together, our side walls and our roof, along with our gable of 200 plus 104, that's going to give you a grand total square foot of surface area of 304. If this gets to be a little complicated for you, or if you have a greenhouse with different shapes where it's hard to do the math, for example, a Gothic arch greenhouse, we have a calculator for you. The link's in the description below. Now that we have this, we need to consider other factors as well. All right, so now on to step two, insulation value. You know, what glazing does your greenhouse actually have? Every greenhouse covering has a different insulation value. For our greenhouse heater calculator, we need the R value or the U value. If you don't know what it is, you can watch the latest video about greenhouse insulation. We'll put the link in the top right corner. Now on to step three. What temperature do you want the greenhouse to be? We can't calculate the BTUs without knowing the temperatures. This also includes the lowest possible temperature you're facing in your local area and the desired internal temperature. Okay, now so for step four, we have to do the math. Now the formula is pretty straightforward. BTUs is going to equal the inside temperature minus your outside temperature multiplied by your surface area divided by your R value. All right, so let's take the JVIC 23 from earlier. It has 4 millimeter glass. We live in a USDA zone 6A with lowest temperature of around negative 10 degrees Fahrenheit. And we want to keep the greenhouse at about 70 degrees Fahrenheit. So the formula would be this. BTU equals 70 minus the negative 10 times 304 divided by our R value, which is 1.2. Now that's going to give you a BTU rating of roughly 20,000, 20,266.67 to be exact. Now that might sound technical, but don't sweat it. Our greenhouse heater calculator will help you. All you need to do is select your greenhouse, put in your temperatures, and then click the calculate button. Very simple. Now, if you can't find your greenhouse model, you just need to know your surface area and your R values. Now, with the right BTU calculations in hand, you'll be well equipped to choose the perfect heater for your space, ensuring comfort, efficiency, and happy plants. So you're geared up to calculate the BTUs needed for your greenhouse. But remember, while math gives us a really good solid starting point, there are factors and limitations to be aware of. Glazing is not the only factor for insulation values. Gaps between the frame and the glazing, as well as around windows and doors, can influence the heat retention. Therefore, the R value based on glazing isn't always an absolute true number. All right, so sunlight distribution is another factor. Part of your greenhouse might receive direct sunlight, while other ones might be shaded. This uneven heating can be pretty tricky to get uniform heating. All right, so let's not forget the humidity levels. You know, high humidity can make the air feel warmer. With low humidity, it does the exact opposite. It can make the air feel a little bit cooler. This can influence the actual heating requirements beyond what the BTUs alone might suggest. Now, ventilation, it plays a part too. You know, proper ventilation ensures even heat distribution, but might also cause it to get a little bit cooler faster, especially if vents and fans are continuously running. Oh, excuse me. Let me shut this window. Now, the truth is, while BTU calculations offer a great baseline, they have their own limitations. Greenhouses are dynamic spaces influenced by many, many factors. All right, so in the end, it's a mix of science and art, mathematics and intuition. Keeping an eye on your plants, adjusting as needed, you'll create the ideal environment for them to flourish. Remember, every greenhouse is unique, and even with this guide, you should keep the results rather flexible. Well, if you like this video, give us a thumbs up and share your experiences or questions in the comments down below. We value your insights and we look forward to learning from your greenhouse journeys. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for more greenhouse tips and tools. Until next time, stay warm and keep those plants happy.